February 20th, 2021. Got a new video for you guys. Okay, guys, I'm back. Well, I got most of the wiring done yesterday. That's what I was doing. Really, I tell you, when you start this project, you may need to make sure you have most of your material. And what I mean by that, all the wiring you're going to need and connectors. That is probably what has slowed me down more than anything. Now, there are a few things that took a while, and I'll show you that. Hold on just a second. This is that blue C fuse block, 12 circuit. It's got the negative bar on it. Now, the only thing, I ran out of wire yesterday. I still have to put one more wire on this, but that's the fuse block itself. I could not find that anywhere in Kansas City here at all. I mean, and I know of a lot of different places where, I mean, you can get a lot of the stuff too here in KC. I mean, first thing I did was call Gray Bar Electric. And, I mean, they were really helpful, but they just did not know where one of these could be found at. And they gave me four other different places to call, and I called a lot of different places, but nobody seemed to have them. Now, I know you can order them, but the problem with the ordering is, depending on who you order from, whether you order through eBay, whether you order through Amazon, how long it takes to get here. And this is what's taken so long on some of this. I want you guys to see that. This here, I actually made up. These are actually two battery terminal ends, basically here, separated. Because I could not find another block for a negative block, so I had to make this up for right now. So I got thinking, I have an inverter, a small inverter, and basically it's not enough to handle all these connectors like that. So what I did, I made this so like an inverter could be actually put here down a line if you had a bigger one, say like a pure sine. Now, let's talk real quick about the wiring. Lowe's has been the best place, actually, to get the wires. Let's see here. The 6-gauge wire, which I brought out of here, the solar controller. This is a positive that's coming down. Now, I purchased these at a Walmart. And I cut one of the ends off. And it seems like they've done pretty good on the way they're, all the power is going through everything. Lines you see here are 4-gauge, okay? This is going through a 50-amp fuse, coming up through here, and they're all meeting up here, okay? And correct right here. Now I'll get to that in a minute. But this is a 170-amp breaker. Now, I ordered it, got it online. I also ordered this 50 amp here, too. This is actually the positive lead coming in from the battery itself. And I'm going to pull this back off here. And this is a 175 amp fuse I bought from O'Reilly's. Now, the ends... The best place probably to get the ends for the connector ends, if you don't order them online, is O'Reilly's. They're pretty much reasonable on that anyway. But some of the other places are pretty high. Lowe's, they're a little bit higher on their stuff. The wiring is very good price-wise. I had to give something like, I think it was... Well, I know what the 2-gauge, this is 2-gauge wire here. I set the system up. I watched this other gentleman. He's got a YouTube channel a while back. I did a lot of research on a lot of this first on hand, but it's called DIY Solar Power with Will Prowse. Not affiliated with any other YouTube channel whatsoever. Check him out. He goes in great detail. I think he's even got every once a week or once a month, he goes live too if you have any questions about any solar and
really good information. Now, these wires here that I used, I could not find a thin strand, guys. I didn't do this wrong, but here in KC, I could. This here on the 6 gauge, okay, it, what they call it here in some places is kind of like welding wire. So, but the thing of it is, what I understand by reading some of this, nobody seems like they want to read. Everybody I run into is like, I'm not an electrician, I don't know. Well, you know, I'm just going to say something real quick for about 30 seconds here. Some of the places I worked at, we had to watch videos and we had to read books to actually be able to work in certain areas. I mean, I've worked at certain different places, from Toys R Us. We had to watch videos on electric cars and bicycles and everything else. It's just unimaginable on some of this stuff here. What they do, I don't know. It's just unreal. But getting back to this, guys. Anyway, where I was going with this on this is that this wire is a lot thicker wire. It's a stiff wire, where these are more flexible. People don't know that. So, but the only thing about the flexible wire, what I understand, is going to have more resistance. So, but the thing of it is, if you're in a vehicle and a car's vibrating, moving up and down, you don't want something that's stiff like this. Okay, you want something that's more flexible, just to kind of make sure everybody understands everything. But since this, when I watched this, Will Prowse do this, on one of these boards, you know, he was talking about putting this, a 400 watt system here in an RV. And that's what I did these wires like for, a 400 watt system. So more panels can be added, 3 more panels could be added, or at least 2 more, depending on this controller. Some say this will handle 4, but it's a 3 definitely. So, pretty simple stuff. Like I say, this has been more of a problem of getting the pieces in for anything, and it has been about almost a week and a half to just, you know, when I get time to look for stuff, it takes, you know, you go to a place, you might stand there 45 minutes, an hour, and, you know, I only have so much time on other things that I do, and it's just unreal. But this system, like I say, should be able to handle at least 300 to 400 watts. Definitely the wiring will be able to on that. Now, the negative, this is the negative side, it's coming up here, and this is the negative battery. So basically, this is just a junction, and this is where basically the end of where it's been terminated right there at the end. So, other than that, like I say, it's been pretty simple. I still have to get one more wire to go from here to over here. Okay, that's what I ran out on. I got my connectors. Now, that is one thing somebody else should explain too, is the connectors are different, of course, different sizes. But the thing of it is, I think some of these are like 5/16, one's a quarter, the other's like 3, this is 3/8. This is 3/8 bolt, I believe, like right there. And these are smaller, of course, and this is about mid-range, okay? So some of the connectors will fit. If you take a full-size 3/8 and try to put on this, it's going to overcome it. Actually, if you see this plastic protruding up, I didn't know if it would make contact. Now, I know you can put washers on it. That's not a problem. But depending on how much, you know, power you're pulling through there. Now, on that DIY, he's got 170 amp breaker. That's what I used because he said it would hold a 400 watt system. This here, the one that I can only find, is only rated, it says right on the deal, it's only rated at 125 on it. 125 on it. Now, he said that there are some that are 150. So
So I don't know for sure. I mean, but like I say, for the amperage, I mean, I think this, I like this setup though. I like the way this box is, because after looking at everything else, there's nothing really else out there that can even compare to it. They don't have them in any of the automotive stores, which I find odd, because the problem with this is, if a guy was putting in a stereo system in a car, it'd be an awesome thing. I mean, I don't understand, and maybe only the your big, like, stereo places, maybe that's all they have. I even checked, like, Best Buy, and they didn't have them. So, I mean, I don't know. I mean, everybody wants you to order them online. So, I don't know. But anyway, once I get my other wire from here over to here, everything will be fully functional. And then I just got to run my wires up to where I want to put my, and my switches up to my lights and my LEDs and stuff. And I'll have everything that I need. I don't know if you guys have ever seen this. I drained the battery a little bit last night too. And I don't know if I've ever showed this to you guys. This is showing, basically, it's charging. It's absorbing the battery. See the little battery phase? And see where it says absorb? Now, when this gets fully charged, this will change and it will say float. Okay? Another thing, at nighttime, it's kind of cool too. At nighttime, when the power shuts off here and there's no power coming in from the solar panel itself, there's a little moon that will appear here, a half moon, crescent moon. And that's kind of cool. But it will, like I say, then it allows you to know that there's no power coming in at that time period. It kind of goes like into like a sleep mode. So, but anyway, that pretty much is my setup. Like I say, I can add more batteries here. I did finally find my plumber strap too for my pipe, and I'm going to get that up there today. But anyway, so at least that's set up now. And it's not that hard. Don't let everybody talk you guys in. I've done a lot of electrical wiring on cars. I mean, I was very good at troubleshooting any electronic and computer problems and stuff on vehicles and stuff. And this isn't that big a deal. Like I say, what I've run into here are these end connectors. And getting back to that, I had to use a drill press. And on a few of these, what I did, I actually just drilled them out a little bit more. Now, I know that that wouldn't, if you were doing that in a house, that wouldn't be correct and that wouldn't meet code. But, you know, this is just for our solar system itself. But it didn't take that much more off. And if you want to get technical, I looked at some other things too. Some of these ends. Now, you take an end like this. Now, this is prefab. Okay, this is the one I bought. Like I say, it's at O'Reilly's. And if you notice that there, that was sticking out a lot more than that. That I actually drilled and made this one here. And the thing of it is, what's interesting about this is I took some snips and cut that metal off, ground it off, and put another hole in there. But the wires actually protrude further into that end connector, where these connectors like this, basically you're just crimping them down, okay? But what I'm saying is on this end here, the wiring goes all the way up, all the way around the way it's been made in the factory there. So just another thing to be heads up. I mean, if you want to get technical, I can get technical. We can get really into it. But like I say, this I made, like I say, I took two strips of piece of copper, I bit them in an L, and I separated this. And I figured that this was good. I think they said up to 600 volts. So I figured it was good enough to be able to push it out from the wall. As long as these two things don't touch, we're fine. I'm going to tape some more of it up today. But I thought I'd leave it open right now until I get this other box done. But anyway, guys, this is just a short little video. And like I say, check out that other guy's channel, though, that DIY Solar Power with Will Prowse. He does some excellent. He gets like solar panels, different ones from all the different ones, and measures the flow of the energy, how much they're all producing and everything. Excellent, excellent stuff.
And like I say, interesting stuff too, but anybody can do it. Don't let anybody talk you guys out of it. They don't let nobody, it seems like here that everybody, you know, nobody wants to do anything, just sit around and party or something. I guess what they like to do here, smoke their weed. But me, I don't know. I think we're living in the age, what's coming, it's going to be a lot more interesting. A lot of stuff coming. And if you do have to survive, you definitely need to have all the knowledge you can. Anyway, guys, have a good one.